about the Great Danes in 3 minutes. The Great Dane, or, on their official name, the German dog, is an extremely calm and balanced breed who have lost much of their original wildness and guardian protective instincts to this day. This is perhaps not a problem, since inserting a colossus of this size into our civilized conditions would certainly not be easy if it were not so. The German dogs are highly human-centered and owner-centered, longing for the physical proximity and touch of the loved ones. We have seen many times a Great Dane standing next to his owner initiating the caress by lifting the owner's hand out of his pocket. They are especially family-friendly, they love children. If the child survives the consequences of the dog's tail flutter without injury, as such a well-intentioned tail stroke can even knock a small child out. Because Great Danes grow slowly, it actually takes 3 years to become fully mature, so it takes a lot of patience and perseverance to train them as well. It is especially difficult that a 6 to 9 month old, still adolescent dog is already bigger and stronger at this age than other adult dogs, and they are not aware of their strength, so early socialization is essential and unavoidable in connection with this breed. For an adult who has already grown to 80 kilograms size and weight is almost impossible to teach what was left out in an early age. In their past, their tasks were the hunting of big game, and since their feeding and maintenance was not a small sum even at that time, they mainly guarded noble yards and castles in German territories. This breed has a huge need for movement, and they like to move. A trained German dog can do long runs well. Just think on that their ancestors accompanied noble carriages trotting for tens of kilometers. They are ideal companions for jogging and long walks, they can keep up easily, and no one dares to harass with the owner, and they like to play with other dogs, as they are not aggressive, they are aware of their size and strength and treat their smaller companions with cool distance and contempt. This breed is not recommended for those who cannot provide them with enough space, enough activity and togetherness, and do not have sufficient financial resources to finance the costs of keeping these giants. Great Danes are also not recommended for neat freaks, as a body of this size produces a lot of hair, and a head of this size produces a lot of drools, which certainly leaves a mark on their surroundings, and you need to change clothes frequently.